The Johannesburg Zoo is preparing for Africa's largest release of the endangered Pickergill Reed frogs into their natural habitat. The frogs play an important role in the ecosystem by helping maintain the food chain balance. The zoo's been running a groundbreaking project to conserve the species. CGTN's Julie Shire was at the project and filed the following story.
The endangered Pickergill Reed frog is endemic to South Africa's KwaZulu-Natal region. It's not bigger than a coin, but its importance to the environment is huge.
They feed on malaria-carrying mosquitoes, which therefore means they can reduce the number of mosquitoes that can infect people. Secondly, frogs are indicator species. So if they exist in an area, you are certain that the environment is clean. Can you imagine they disappear in KwaZulu-Natal? And there is nothing that controls mosquitoes in that particular region where they exist. It is definitely going to be catastrophic to the people that live around that area.
Threats from invader fungi species, global warming and habitat loss means these frogs are disappearing fast. The Johannesburg Zoo and Inzimvelo KZN Wildlife have undertaken a groundbreaking project to save the pickergill from the brink of extinction.
We are now breeding them in a captive environment under suitable and specialized designed environment and conditions to ensure that we can take them back. To date, we have really released 372 specimens, and we are also doing post-release monitoring that we found that they're actually adapting. They're doing fantastic.
Animal specialists here are now preparing the next army of 400 frogs in a specialized lab at the zoo. The amphibians will soon be moved to the KwaZulu-Natal wetlands.
It's very difficult to take care of these frogs. It's hours and hours of monitoring and record keeping and evaluation taking place. We need to mimic the environment in here as closely as possible to the environment in the natural habitat in KwaZulu-Natal. We're looking at temperatures, humidity, environment, social structure, and we have to keep a very close eye on that.
It's the biggest release of the species in Africa and has to be timed perfectly.
You can't release them before it starts raining, because it had to rain, it must be wet in that area, there must be food for them. Because if there's no rain, there won't be food for them.
The landmark breeding project sets a precedent for similar projects around the world. Without the Pickergill Reed frogs, the South African environmental ecosystem faces a significant risk. Julie Shara, CGTN, Johannesburg, South Africa.